In this video, I describe shade tolerance by defining the term and then talking about characteristics associated with being tolerant or intolerant to shade. So, what is shade tolerance? Broadly speaking, shade tolerance defines the ability to survive and/or grow under shaded conditions. And often we kind of operationalize this by defining it as the minimum light level for survival and/or growth. A key trade-off that really determines shade tolerance results from the fact that photosynthesis or carbon gain is tightly coupled to respiration, which is the loss of carbon due to metabolic activity of the plant. Just a little side note on this, when we're thinking about high light environments, photosynthesis is usually about 10 times greater than respiration. This ratio is a little bit less as we get into shade. But basically, there is a trade-off between having high photosynthetic rates, but also having high respiration rates. This is a set of graphs that basically look across many, many species in many different types of forests from the tropics, shown in this Venezuela squares here, to temperate Wisconsin, and all of the points are summarized here. Each point here is a different species, different tree species, and what you can see is that as photosynthetic rates increase, so high photosynthetic rates are associated with high dark respiration rates. So, when you have high photosynthetic rates, you really have to invest in pretty expensive biochemical machinery, and it's expensive from a metabolic perspective, right? So, if you have high rates of photosynthesis, you have to maintain all of those biochemical characteristics, and to do that, you have to have a high respiration rate. So it's kind of a trade-off between being a tortoise or a hare. So you can either have high photosynthetic rates when light's abundant, but lose too much energy to survive in the shade because you have high respiration rates, or you can be really energy efficient, survive in the shade, but have photosynthesis that's really too low to be competitive in high light. So low respiration rates allow low light survival, but doesn't make that plant particularly competitive in a high light environment. So one the aspect of this tolerance has to do with leaf physiological tolerance. And so this graph shows you a light response curve of photosynthesis. Across the x-axis, we have light availability running from no light and very low light to high light availability. And then this is just looking at net photosynthesis. So this is carbon gained minus the carbon loss. So we've already taken into account respiration. And what we see here are two different curves. Cyania pilosa, shown in green, is a shade tolerant species. It has low respiration rates, but it also has high or low photosynthetic rates at high light. And because of its low respiration rates, compared to the shade intolerant Claremontia parviflora, at low light levels, the tortoise, the shade tolerant species, is the winner. Whereas when we move out to high light levels here, the hare, or the shade intolerant species, is a winner. So this is really a trade-off that's related to leaf physiological tolerance. Closer to home, here are some more local species, and we can see that at high light levels, paper birch is going to have higher rates of physiological rates than sugar maple. But when we get down into low light, we see that sugar maple at very low lights has an advantage over these two species. How does this translate to growth and survival? So this graph depicts five species from northern hardwood forests. And on the top graph, We're looking at growth in grams per gram of tissue per year. And at the bottom, we're looking at survival, what proportion of the seedlings survived. Black is at 2% light, so low light. Gray is 8%, still pretty low, but higher than the others. And what you'll see here is that in high light, paper birch is the winner. It has the highest growth rates compared to the other species. However, in low light, in the black bars, ironwood and sugar maple are the winners with higher growth rates than the other species. And these patterns are really shared in the survival as well, so they're mirrored. In high light, yellow birch and paper birch have the highest survival. In low light, it's the ironwood and the sugar maple that have the highest survival. And indeed, paper birch and yellow birch have no survival in the shade. They're not able to tolerate the shade. So what we see is that leaf shade tolerance is linked to whole plant growth and survival trade-offs. So we get these two strategies that are associated with a suite of different characteristics. We have our intolerant, shown as the aspen trees here, that have high photosynthetic rates but also high respiration rates. This fuels rapid growth because they're fast growing and have high physiological rates. Their leaves are pretty cheap, and so they don't allocate a lot to herbivores. If herbivores eat their leaves, well, they'll just grow some more. They grow fast. They have low density wood. They tend to have very high seedling mortality, and this is often related to these seedlings having high light requirements and the proportion of the landscape that's in high life and light. And overall, these trees are shorter lived. So this is the, you know, live fast, die young kind of strategy. In contrast, our sugar maple tree here, the shade tolerant species, it has low respiration rates, so low energy cost, but comes at the cost of low carbon gain. This leads to slow growth rates because they grow slowly and those tissues tend to be highly valued. This is actually especially true in evergreen shade tolerant species. We get high allocation to herbivore defense, high density wood related to slow growth rate, as well as the fact that they're going to spend a fair amount of their lifespan in the understory, which is low light but also has hazards of things falling on them and killing them from above. So we have high density wood, and these characteristics together are associated with lower seedling mortality for the species. And overall, this strategy is associated with a longer lifespan. So this is kind of, this is, as we mentioned, the tortoise, the slow and steady wins the race in terms of a long lifespan. The last characteristic that I want to talk about related to shade tolerance is the phenology of species. And you could call this a shade avoidance strategy, but a number of very shade tolerant species tend to put their leaves out prior to the canopy closing. So this is a seedling strategy, I guess. This is something that might be associated with juveniles and juvenile shade tolerance. They put their leaves out early before the canopy closes in this time period where there's a lot of light. And so they gain lots and lots of carbon during this early period, and that carbon allows them to withstand and survive over the more low light conditions that accompanied the summer. So I want to leave you with just a list of shade tolerance ratings for a number of our local tree species. This is something that you might don't need to memorize the exact numbers, but in terms of the class and your careers, especially if you're going to stay locally, you're going to want to have a sense for relative rankings of these different species because they are important in terms of understanding regeneration potential, in terms of making management decisions, and in terms of how these species interact with the heterogeneity of light on the forest landscape.